Hello, I'm Sebastian. Welcome to Nine Trees Podcast. Today I will summarize and review the book, In Bad Therapy, Why the Kids Aren't Growing Up. Abigail Shrier embarks on a critical exploration of the contemporary therapeutic culture and its impact on the development of young people. Through a meticulously researched narrative, Shrier argues that modern therapeutic practices, rather than fostering resilience and independence, are impeding the natural maturation process of children and adolescents. With a sharp eye for detail and a commitment to journalistic integrity, the author examines the paradigm shifts within educational systems, family dynamics, and social media influences that have paved the way for therapy to become a default response to the ordinary challenges of growing up. This book paints a concerning picture of a generation being taught to externalize blame and rely on professional intervention for minor setbacks, thus entering adulthood without the skills to navigate life's ups and downs. I will give you key takeaways from this book. Firstly, The Rise of Therapeutic Culture. Abigail Shrier traces the origins and expansion of therapeutic culture, showing how it has permeated educational settings, pop culture, and even the legal system. This chapter dissects the well-intentioned yet misguided belief that self-esteem is paramount, leading to educational policies and parenting styles that prioritize sheltering children from failure and discomfort over preparing them for the real challenges of life. Shrier argues that this shift towards constant validation and away from resilience-building experiences has left young people ill-equipped to face adversity. With a detailed analysis, the section depicts how societal focus on feelings and personal truths at the expense of objective reality and hard work has contributed to a fragility among the younger generation, making them less prepared for independent life. Secondly, the pathologization of normal development. Shrier delves into the medicalization of normal emotional states and developmental stages, detailing how behaviors previously considered part of growing up are now often labeled as mental health disorders. This overdiagnosis, she argues, encourages reliance on professional intervention and pharmacological solutions for everyday challenges, minimizing the importance of learning through experience. The author provides compelling evidence of the surging rates of anxiety, depression, and other mental health diagnoses among the youth, questioning whether these are genuine increases in pathology or a product of societal and cultural shifts towards over-medicalization. Through interviews with experts and analysis of scientific research, Shrier presents a critical view of how this trend towards pathologization has stunted personal growth and resilience among young people. Thirdly, social media's role in shaping identity. This section explores the profound impact of social media on identity formation and the therapeutic culture's integration into these digital spaces. Shrier illustrates how platforms like Instagram, Snapchat, and TikTok have created environments where external validation, through likes and follows, supersedes self-discovery and genuine social interaction. The author highlights the dangers of these virtual echo chambers, including increased anxiety, depression, and a distorted sense of self-worth based on superficial metrics. Furthermore, Shrier discusses how social media facilitates a form of performative therapy, where individuals publicly share personal struggles not as a means of genuine expression, but for attention and validation, further entrenching the idea that normal emotional experiences require therapeutic intervention. Fourthly, the impact on family dynamics. Abigail Shrier addresses the transformation in family dynamics, with a particular focus on how therapeutic culture has altered parent-child relationships. Parents, driven by a desire to protect their children from any form of distress, often resort to therapeutic language and solutions, inadvertently signaling to their children that they are fragile and incapable of overcoming obstacles without professional help. Shrier presents case studies and interviews with families to illustrate the shift from traditional parenting roles, which emphasized independence and self-sufficiency, to a more involved and, arguably, overbearing approach. This section questions the long-term effects of these changes on children's ability to mature into competent, resilient adults, and suggests that the current trend may be doing more harm than good. Lastly, the quest for authentic resilience. In the final part of her argument, Shrier proposes a reevaluation of society's approach to adversity and personal development. She advocates for a return to embracing life's challenges as opportunities for growth, rather than obstacles that necessitate therapeutic intervention. Drawing on historical perspectives, emerging research, and contemporary anecdotes, Shrier makes a compelling case for cultivating genuine resilience, the ability to recover from setbacks and thrive in the face of difficulties. She offers practical advice for educators, parents, and individuals on fostering environments that encourage independence, critical thinking, and perseverance. By highlighting examples of successful interventions that promote these values, Shrier provides a hopeful pathway forward, away from the pitfalls of bad therapy, and towards a future where young people are equipped to navigate the complexities of adult life with confidence and competence. In conclusion, in Bad Therapy, Why the Kids Aren't Growing Up, Abigail Shrier offers a provocative critique of the modern therapeutic culture and its ramifications on the development of young people. Her thorough research and insightful analysis make a compelling case for reconsidering the widespread application of therapy as a panacea for the challenges of growing up. This book is a must-read for educators, parents, policymakers, and anyone concerned with the future well-being of our society's youth. It illuminates the unintended consequences of well-meaning interventions and underscores the importance of resilience, self-reliance, and coping skills as foundations for a healthy transition into adulthood. Shrier's work provides valuable insights and practical solutions for those seeking to promote authentic development and independence in young people, making it an essential contribution to the conversation on mental health and societal progress. If you would like to support Abigail Shrier, you can buy the book through the Amazon link I've provided in the podcast description. After reading the book, please let me know what you think and share your thoughts. See you around.